call to open the meeting. Is there a motion?
Motion to open the meeting.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Okay, it sounds like Mr. Bleedle is looking to have a volunteer chair this evening, and I will do that if the board so chooses. Is there a motion?
Motion to have Bob Brown.
I would like to make a motion to have Bob Brown chair.
Okay, thank you. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
So let's get right underway here. First thing we have to do is approve the minutes from January 12th. I know they were sent out with everybody's packet. Has everybody had a chance to read them? Go over that. Yeah.
Motion to move, approve the minutes as printed.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
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 So moved. We're all set with those. Do you have any meeting mail we need to go over first, Amanda, before we get right into business here?
We do not.
Okay. So jumping right in with old business / new business, the case of New England Farms. It sounds like, Mr. Lombardo, you want a continuance, so we don't need to really get it. I think we're on board with that. We need a little bit of well, I'll let you stop, Mr. Lombardo.
Yeah, thank you, sir. We do have a planning board meeting next month, March 18th, and I think that it makes sense to defer once again this meeting until we can meet with the planning board. So with respect to both of the cases on the special permit and the sign permit request, I would ask this board to continue us to a date after March 18th of next month, March 18th.
Sounds great. I couldn't agree with you more. My biggest thing, contention with this whole thing was I really believe the planning board should be leading it, and then we just voting on this, the size of the building and the signage that you're looking for. So the further you get along with them, I think the easier decision it's going to be for us. I do have some questions as to whether, you know, the size of the building is okay, but does it leave you enough parking and things like that? So the further you get along with the planning board, the more comfortable I'm going to be. Does the board agree? And would you like to give Mr. Lombardo a continuance till the next meeting?
I would like to make a motion to continue it to board. How does the 23rd work for everybody? That's the Tuesday, March 23rd.
March 23rd. Do we have anything else?
We do have one more case.
Okay, good.
That's
right,
coming
okay.
in. That date work, we'll continue them to March 23rd.
Okay.
Sounds like a motion. Is there a second?
Yep.
Is there a time on that?
It'll be at 6:30.
Thank you.
Yep.
What do we got? March 28th.
Was there a second?
I'll second that.
All in favor?
Thank you.
Aye.
Aye. I do want to say, however, in regards to this New England Farms case, because I know there are people that have been following it, our board and what's going to be voted on, hopefully that night will be have more information to be able to vote, but it's only going to be strictly on the size of the building and the signage only. Anything else is going to be stuff that's discussed by planning board. So I just want people to know, and I have every intention of talking to some other departments in town to getting comments so we can vote on this hopefully sooner rather than later, because it's been put off and put off. But we are only going to discuss the size of the building and the signage only. Correct. And I just want that point known, because I know there have been people following it, but I want to make sure that the appropriate questions and concerns are handled by the appropriate people.
I will give you that we will have a new set of plans to hand out to everybody way prior to the meeting. I'm hoping at least a week or 2 weeks ahead of time. Mr. Lombardi has guaranteed me that we will have another set of plans, and I will hand them out to all the heads. If I need to hand them out to you guys, I will hand them out to you guys. Can you make some extra copies of those, Mr. Lombardo?
I'll do my best.
That's all I can ask.
Okay, thank you both. There is a motion and a second to continue this. until the next meeting, which is going to be on March 23rd, did you say? At 6:30. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Thank you. All right, our next case. And before you, I think he's gone.
No, I'm back.
I'm sorry. It goes without saying that we're going to continue both cases. I just want to make that clear and far and on the record that we're also continuing the second case 20201020 on the signs as well. So
thank you.
I think we got to make it a second motion if somebody would, please.
I will make that motion to continue case 2020.10.20A as well to March 23rd at 6:30.
Second, please.
Second.
Okay.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
I just want to be clear to the public. There are two separate cases. They will be voted on separately, and we're continuing both of them. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. The next case, C, 2021.02.23A, is case of Kevin Murray, of 75 Lambert Street, Acushnet, petitioning for a variance to be able to change the lot lines on his properties located at 7 and 9 Kendrick Street, Acushnet, making the 7 Kendrick Street lot more nonconforming. This request is being made under the provisions of Section 331E Development Standards. I just want to be clear on this. We went over this. Mr. Murray, can you hear us? I can't see you anymore, but I know you're there.
Oh, yes, I can.
Very good. Okay. Yep. So we went over this at our last meeting, and there was a little bit of back and forth of whether or not it belonged here. After speaking with the rest of the department heads, it should be settled here so that they can move properly to the planning board. We went over this extensively in the last meeting, so I'm not going to get into it too much unless there is there any abutters who want to speak on this again? There was none at the last meeting. There was nobody to talk about it. Basically, Mr. Murray owns both lines, and he needs to move the line in order to put his new septic tank on the property of the house it's for. It does make the lot more nonconforming, but it makes the other one much more conforming. And really, he's only shifting his own land from one to the other. It doesn't affect any abutters or anybody else around. All it does is keep the septic system on his property. He's looking to move 2,200 feet, I believe. I'm just going to... 2,200 square feet from 9 Kendrick to 7 Kendrick. And what it's going to do is allow his septic system to be on the property that goes with the house. And again, he owns both properties. His driveway is now going to be on the property. It was so simple at the last meeting that we didn't think it needed to be done, but we need to do it here. So I'll ask if the board has any questions, concerns, or if you'd like to move forward with a motion.
Motion to approve.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
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 I'm just going to ask everybody with the eyes to raise hands. So because we are in a Zoom mode, everybody can see it. It is Mr. Hippolito. I can't see anymore. We have four. Can Paul hear us?
Paul, you still here? Maybe he left. Maybe shut down.
It looks like he froze.
Yeah.
I'm going to say that irregardless, the motion passes 4 to 0, basically. He's not voting either way, so the variance is approved, Mr. Murray.
Okay.
You can speak with Amanda briefly, that she'll tell you how to move forward.
Okay, thank you.
All the paperwork will be filed in the town clerk's office. You can give them a call by next week. There is a waiting period. I believe it's 20-day appeal period. And after that, they will provide you with a letter for whatever you need to take care of for further after.
All righty.
I apologize, Mr. Murray, for the inconvenience of having to come back this meeting. It was between the boards. We were a little undecided. You've got it taken care of.
Yep.
Thank you.
Have a good night.
Okay, next case, case 021-02.
Apologize. She's gonna, next week, call the town clerk's office. They'll have all the paperwork for me, and then I have to grab that, and then I have to wait 20 days.
Hey, Eric, can you mute that?
I think Amanda can mute it.
Yeah, I usually can, and they didn't give me the ability today.
I don't even know who's talking.
Thank you.
It's Mr. Murray.
Okay, he's gone. We're good.
Okay.
Moving forward, case 2021.02.23.B, case of Charles and Lisa Leonard of 764 Main Street, Acushnet, who are petitioning for variance for release of the side setback to be able to center construction of a new proposed dwelling provision being made under section 339C3. I see Mr. Leonard is here this evening.
How are you, board?
Plot plan, Mr. Leonard, I'll let you open up.
Well, excuse me. This goes back to development we started 17 years ago, and there was a building window that this second lot, I built in the third lot, I don't know the exact footage of it was, but the house I'm putting on right now, the garage extends in over the invisible line for 75 feet, 3 feet from my garage. This lot is a lot I've had a permit for originally, the buildable lot. I had the permit 16 years ago. Septic's approved, everything's been approved, the well's already been in. I've sat on a lot. We haven't changed anything. The only thing we're asking for is the garage hangs over that 75-foot line by 3 feet.
It looks like you're going on both sizes.
The porch in the front, correct. The porch in the front and the garage, the back corner of the garage, and the porch in front. Both of them are non-livable because the garage is trusses. It's just 3 feet in the garage, and the front is actually porch.
I just want to make sure what we vote on, if you're approved, gives you what you need. The 69-foot proposed gives you everything you need for the porch, and the 71-foot 8. On the back side gives you everything you need.
Exactly, that's it. Right there, what that drawing you guys have, that's all I need.
So this is, as you're all aware, a retreat lot, 75-foot setbacks, much like the one we put a variance on for similar reasons over by the golf course behind Mr. Chopper's home a few months back. Basically, they're not looking to put the dwelling closer to any of the property lines than needed, other than to fit it on the property. Again, a few months back, we had a similar one, and I think about the same footage. We were moving 4 or 5 feet on one side to make it fit. They are putting it in the center of the lot, as they should be, rather than hugging any of the neighbors, because this is a retreat lot. So everybody does have the plan in front of them, right? Knows what's going on here?
Yep.
Yes.
Okay. Is there any questions? Any abutters? Again, much like the last one, I think when you do these retreat lots and you come to this and you need provisions to get closer than the 75 feet, it would be abutters who I would be listening to most. So if there is any. So you know anyone from the board want to add any input? I see Mr. Merritt just signed in. Oh, I'm sorry. Joe, do you have something to say?
No, I'm just in a butter to Chuck. I don't have a problem with that. With that variance, I just don't know if this is the place to ask. I'd like to probably talk to Chuck and see if there's a way we put some kind of maybe some trees, just to kind of have a better buffer.
Oh, absolutely. I'm looking at that. The other day, I was looking at the same thing. In the wintertime, I just started seeing your house. I'm like, well, I'm so used to growing, my back house, they're not seeing anybody's. So, actually, when I was over there walking around, now that everything's dead in the wintertime, I was thinking the same thing. I'll take care of the Apophytes on my land, because between us, there's a stone wall. That's our property line. But there's a 35-foot right away to the back property. But I'll have room. I can put something to give us a little more, buffer. No problem. I'll work with you.
Thank you. Appreciate that. That's all.
Joe, I know who we are, but could you state who you are and maybe tell me what lot you're? Do you know if you're map 8, lot 13, or lot 10?
Yep, I'm lot 8, Joseph Costello, 780 Main, lot 8.
Okay, so there is actually a right
is
that away.
Lot? Is it map 8, lot 13?
Yes.
13F or 13G?
I want to say it's 13F. Okay. It's number 8. I apologize. I don't have that in front of me.
No, it's map. You look like a Hollywood star. What are you on? Yeah, DMZ there, Joe?
I'm in a car.
I'm driving. All right, Joe. All right, Joe. Joe is actually thinking about cutting a trail through so we could use the pool, but we'll talk about that after.
Yeah, okay, that's another time.
So, Joe, I'm going to just ask you one thing. Are you happy with the answer to that, or are you looking for the board to put that in any kind of contingency upon this variance?
No, I'm okay. I take Chuck at his word. I'm all right with that. Okay.
Thank you, Joe.
Any other questions? I see Mr. Mara, our building inspector, has signed on. Do you have anything?
No, I'm good. I mean, this is a typical situation for, we've had it in a couple of times, just that some of the lots that have been approved, the 75-foot setbacks really make the area where you can build something very small. Okay. And this happens to be one of those cases.
Okay. Any other questions or comments?
I have none. I'd like to make a motion to approve the request.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. All in favor?
Aye.
Can you raise our hands, please, so I can? Thank you. You're approved, Mr. Leonard.
Thank you, board. Good night. Thank you.
Good night, everybody.
You're welcome.
Does he have to go to town hall to sign some papers, Amanda? Yep. Okay.
Yeah, I would call them by next week. Everything should be all set.
All right, thank you.
All right, that's all the cases we have this evening. Is there any other newer or old business from the board we should discuss?
No, we did have one case come in, so it'll be one case in addition to the New England Farms on the 23rd.
Ask for a motion to adjourn.
I will make that motion to adjourn.
I will second it.
All in favor?
Aye.
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 Have a good night, guys.